Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to continue for our rooftop bypass tool in Revit. In our previous tutorial, we are talking about how to model our rooftop by adaptive panel in Revit. So today I'm going to continue to press our rooftop in our Revit architecture template, and of course I will provide you a quick instruction to apply our root structure also. And before I get things started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out here and you want to learn how to create root tile in the whole process, you need to take a look on my previous tutorial on the you come back here for watching for part 2. It's easier for you to connection with our tutorial. Okay, so now let's switch into our project together. As you can see on my screen, here is my root tile that I create one that I apply into my project. And if I take a look on my 3D, there is our previous tutorial, is our root tile component. And another one is a reference well for our root tile also for component when we apply into our project. And here is a final procession. We got our root tile, we got our steel structure, rectangle hollow section steel for our structure rules. So today we're going to continue to create the whole process together. So now I think we need to create a new template first. Control N on my keyboard for new shortcut key. Then I'm going to finding for metric architecture template. Then I can hit OK. Okay, so here we are in Revit architecture template. So what I'm going to do in order to make our process, first thing I need to load all of my component first. So I went back to my 3D over there, then I just load into and close because I don't want already, just load into project 2, then hit okay. Then I'm going to load another one first. I need to load this guy over there. Just load in, load and close also to project 2. Okay, so now we load our component already. It's time to make our root tile. First thing, I need to hit escape first because we are working on placing component. I need to hit escape a couple times. Then I will turn on for 3D default. Then I just close this one and I will hide all my elevation first. Okay, so I need to hide all of them. Behave. Okay, I think I need to hide all of them by visibility graphic. Let's me hide them by visibility graphic first. VG on my keyboard. Then we just finding for character L. Then apply. Then it's okay. Okay, now it's pretty much to create our root tile. I will start from top view over there. Then go to our architecture tab on toolbar. Then go to our rules here. We just make it for level 2 and yes. Then I will simply using for rectangle. For basic rule, I will adjustment it. Just make it for 125 mm. And I will start to it up like this. And I will adjustment here. Just make it for 4 meter. And make here for 12 meter. Hit escape a couple of time. For those sloping here, I want to turn off. I will select two of them like this. Then just define slope for turn off. Then I can apply, as you can see here. Now we got our simple rules already. And of course, if you want to change for your rules component and add some waterproofing, you need to go to your edit type over there. Then go to edit structure and you need to add another one. Let's say I want to add for waterproofing. I will just go to insert tab. Then I will make it up. Just move it up like this. And I will make it for 100. Then I make this one for 25 and make this guy over there for finish one. Then I can hit okay. And here you need to apply for material, but I don't want to wasting time for the process. I just give you a quick tip here. Then I can hit okay. If you need to apply your material tile, you need to apply here. I can hit okay first. Apply. That's okay. As you can see here, now I got a two different rule. The first one is our basic rule and the second one is our waterproofing. Now it's time to apply our root tile. First thing, I need to set a plan first. I will set a plan and pick a plan. set it for this rule over there. Then I can go to our meshing inside, go to in-place mask, then I can open up. Once I open that, I am in mask mode, so I'm going to go to rectangle over there. Then I will try to draw it up like this, as you can see here. Hit escape. Then I'm going to create our mask. Just create mask, solid mask like this. Then I will adjustment it, make it for 2 mm. Hit escape. Then I can select all of them like this for our solid form. Device surface. And I will adjustment for our U grill there. Just make it 300, same as our rotile previous one. I will make it 300 or so. Hit apply. Then I need to adjustment our grid also. I will make it from just justification from center to beginning, and here as well. Hit apply. And of course, I want to rotate it for 90 degrees or so. Like this. Hit apply. Okay, perfect. Then I can drop down on my property panel there. Finding for rules curve temperature pattern best here. As you can see here, it's applied quite properly and quite nice. As you can see here, but I think we need to adjustment here first. Let's make it 4-0. Let's apply because it's a different direction. Okay, this direction is correctly as you can see here. But I think we need to move up a bit because we'll be overlapping with our rule, as you can see here. Then I'm going to move it up. Just start from front view over there. Then I can move it up. MV. Then I will just move it up for about 40. Don't worry about that because later on we need to apply our rule structure also. I think it's better a lot. It's time to apply another one, but I will turn on for hidden line because I don't want my file to think. I'm going to set a plan again. We need to set another rule here. Then simply using our rectangle, we simply draw it up like this. Draw until here. Then I just hit escape first. Select all my element for line here. Create form, solid form again. And same process before, we will make it for 2 mm. 2 mm and I just divide surface, make it for 300 by 300, same as before, 300. Here is our previous process. We just repeat that. Hit apply. As you can see here, then for justification here, I will change it to beginning and change here to beginning as well. Hit apply. Okay, we just go to our property again, then drop down finding for Ruska Tempanel here. Okay, let me see first. Okay, here we need to rotate. It's a different angle. Okay, perfect. Select here again. Then I will start from front side here. Then I just move it up. Just move it up for 40 mm. Hit escape a couple of times. Now it's perfectly. It's time to place another rules on center here. I just hit finish up first. First thing, I need to go to my level 2 to apply our rules on top here. Okay, here, come on. Because while it's regenerating, we'll be take a few seconds on that. So I can go to my level 2 over there. Okay, then create another reference plan, or you can directly press that CM on my keyboard for plus 11. Then I will start plus from here. Until here. Hit escape a couple of times. Let's go to our 3D again. And here you need to move it up. I will start from front side here, like this. Then I just simply move it. Start from, let me see first, where is it? Where is the center point here? Okay, we just move from here, zoom out until here. Okay, as you can see here, It's quite perfectly. So now it's time to create our root structure. First thing, I need to go to my structure there in order to make it. And I will load my project because as per our Revit architecture template, we got only four universal beams. So I need to load another file there because I want to load our rectangle hollow section still. Now I am in steel tab for structural framing. I will load for hollow section steel structure. Just hit open up. Once I open that, will be specify tie a lot that I need to selecting, but I will choose whatever I want because later on I can adjustment it. I will using for a smaller one. Then I just go to edit tie over there. Just make it for 50 by 50. Then we need to rename it. Rename it for HHS 50 by 50. Then I can apply, then it's okay. Once I open that, I need to go to architecture tab again, then go to set a plan. I will set for bottom over rule over there, set here. Then again, we go to our structure, beam system, turn on for rectangle tool here. Then I can start from here until here. Let me see first, I could not connect that like this. Then I will make our distance is just make it for quick distance, make it for 300 by 300. Hit apply. Then I can hit finish. Okay, perfect. Then again, I need to copy to clipboard, align to same level, and edit boundary, change our beam direction, change to here. Like this, it finished. Okay, perfect. Then I will start from front view like this. I need to move it down. Just move it down like this. I think like this will do. Let me move it again. Okay, perfect. As you can see here, then I can select all of them here. Hold Control key for multiple selection. Let me select all of them first. SA for select all. Go to our level 2. Then I can draw mirror. I will start draw mirror like this. Just delete some element. Don't worry about that. Go to our 3D over there. Okay, we could not because it's overlapping. So I'm going to repeat our process, or you can create another reference plan there, but I'm going to placing another process over there. Just set a plan again because I don't want to create our reference plan, but you can create your reference plan to mirror that. But I don't like to use this style because I think because it's our habit. We'll start from here again. Yep, and I will make it again. Hit finish. Copy to clipboard. Align to same plans. Then change beam direction. Change to vertical. Hit finish. Start from our front view again to adjustment it, and I will select all of them again. Select the whole system. I mean, we need to select the whole system. Let me select it out first. Okay, start from front. Then we need to move it. Okay, perfect. As you can see here, basically you need to create a two different structure here. One is here and another one is a top here. So now I'm going to adjustment. Now I will select all of them like this. Select here again. Yep, start from front and I just move it up for 15 millimeter, like this. Don't worry about that. Okay, so here I'm going to select all of them again. SA for select all, CO for copy. Then I can, okay, I could not copy that, as you can see here. The structure here also wrong because coming one only, as you can see here. So we need to delete that and take all of them back because it's coming one only. So I'm going to select all of them again. Start from front here. And V for move. Just move it down like this. Okay, this time is perfect. SA for select all. Then we start from front here. CO for copy. Let's see how we can copy or not. Can, I think this time it's can. Make it until here. Okay, as you can see here, it's quite nice and quite perfect. When I turn on for realistic, let's turn on for realistic, as you can see here. But here you need to adjustment more because it goes see-through with our rectangle holosystem still. And I know you guys know how to move already. You just like all of them there, then just move it up about 2 millimeter or 3 millimeter will do. Okay, as you can see here, guys, it's quite nice. And here, of course, you can change for material also. Let me change it out, just like here. Then go to our type. I will change our from our Spanish root tile to copper color, same as our root tile here. Finding for copper. Here, I think. Control V is applied. Then it's okay. As you can see here. And for the structure, I just reminding you need to select another root tile here and another one. And for the top here, you just move it up about 2 millimeter. We'll do for this part here. Okay, guys, I think it's pretty much for explanation and pretty much for the tutorial. I hope you guys learned something new about that. Thank you guys for watching. And if you like this tutorial and you are first time with reaching out here and or visiting to my channel and you want to learn more about Revit, make sure hit subscribe button below and click the bell icon for turn on notification so you won't miss my future tutorial. Okay guys, thank you for watching and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.